हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू इन लेक्चर नंबर 13 ऑन टू डायमेंशनल रैंडम वेरिएबल्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू ऑफ टू डायमेंशनल रैंडम वेरिएबल। सो बिफोर गोइंग फॉर दिस डेफिनेशन, वी रिकॉल द एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू फॉर वन डायमेंशनल रैंडम वेरिएबल। सो वी नो दैट इफ एक्स इज ए रैंडम वेरिएबल, देन एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स is denoted by e of x, or we can write in this notation also, either this square bracket or this small bracket, and is defined as, if x is a discrete random variable, it is defined as sigma x times probability mass function of x, summation is over all possible values of x. And if x is a continuous random variable, this summation is replaced by integral from minus infinity to infinity x times fx, which is probability density function of x. And we have also seen that if instead of x we have function of x, so expected value of function of random variable x is given by sigma. Here I will replace x by g of x times probability mass function of x, summation is over all possible values of x, and here we will replace this x by gx if x is a continuous random variable. So the definition for two dimensional random variable is also same. Suppose this order pair xy is a two dimensional random variable, and suppose this h is a function of these two random variables x and y, then if x and y both are discrete random variables, then expected value of function of this two dimensional random variable is given by, because we have two random variables, we have to consider summation over all possible values of both the random variables. Here we will write hxy, and in the product we write joint probability mass function of this two dimensional random variable. Similarly, if both the variables are continuous, then this double summation will be replaced by double integral. This is minus infinity to infinity, and instead of joint probability mass function we will write joint probability density function of both the random variables. So this is either dx dy or dy dx, depending upon the given problem. So this is the definition for expected value of a function of random variable. Your function of two dimensional random variable may be like this. You can have x plus y, or you may have x into y, or you can have different functions, x square minus 2xy plus y square. So if you have any function of two dimensional random variable, then expected value of h of xy is given by double summation hxy into probability mass function if both the variables are discrete, and if both the variables are continuous, this expected value is given by this double integral of hxy times joint probability density function. So with this in mind, we start today's lecture. Here we have written all these things systematically. So first we read this definition, expected value of two dimensional random variable. Let x and y be jointly distributed random variables with probability mass function pxy if both are discrete, and joint probability density function fxy if both are continuous, according to whether the variables are discrete or continuous. Then the expected value of a function hxy is denoted by e of hxy or mu suffix hxy, and is defined in this way. If x and y both are discrete, then we have double summation hxy times pxy, summation is over all possible values of x and y. And if both variables are continuous, this expected value is given by double integral of hxy times joint probability density function. We have one result for expected value of two dimensional random variable. Let x and y be jointly distributed random variables, then expected value of ax plus by, that is expected value of linear combination of x and y. Ax plus by is nothing but linear combination of these two random variables x and y. Here a and b are arbitrary constants. So expected value of ax plus by is always equal to a times expected value of x plus b times expected value of y. So this result is helpful in doing some problems. If you don't want to go for this definition, then you can separately find out expected value of x and expected value of y, and you can find out expected value of linear combination of x and y. Here a and b are any constants. So with this definition in mind and with this result in our mind, we try to do this example, which is on the expected value of two dimensional random variable. So we first understand what is given. A certain market has both an express checkout line and a super express checkout line. Let x1 denote the number of customers in line at the express checkout at a particular time of day, and x2 denote the number of customers in line at the super express checkout at the same time. Suppose the joint probability mass function of x1 and x2 is as given in the following table. So this is the joint probability mass function of random variables x1 and x2. All these table values give us this type of values, p of x1, x2, that is values of joint probability mass function of x1, x2 at these different points. X1 takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. X2 takes the values 0, 1, 2 and 3. So as it is given, x1 denotes the number of customers in line at the express checkout and x2 denotes the number of customers in line at the super express checkout. So number of customers are always discrete, so this x1 and x2 both are discrete random variable, and that is the reason why we are given joint probability mass function of x1 and x2. Now the difference between the number of customers in line at the express checkout and the number in the line at the super express checkout is nothing but x1 minus x2, and we are asked to calculate the expected difference, that is we are asked to find out expected value of x1 minus x2. We have to find out expected value of x1 minus x2, where x1 takes the value 0 to 4, x2 takes the value 0 to 3, and these table values are values of joint probability mass function of these two random variables x1 and x2. So as we discussed, by the definition, expected value of this difference, that is expected value of x1 minus x2, will be equal to double summation times our function is x1 minus x2. So here we write x1 minus x2 times value of joint probability mass function at point x1, x2. Here we consider x2. X2 has possible values 0, 1, 2, 3. So this summation is from x2 equal to 0 to 3. This summation is for all possible values of x1, which are from 0 to 4. So using this, we can find out expected value of this difference of x1 and x2. So first, what we can do is we can find out this summation by considering x1 as fixed. So first we fix x1 and we vary x2. So we can have, if we take x2 equal to 0, we can have x1 minus 0, that is x1 into px1 0 plus, for x2 equal to 1, we have x1 minus 1 into px1 1. Similarly, for x2 equal to 1, we can have x1 minus 2 px1 2. And for x2 equal to 3, we can have x1 minus 3 px1 3. So, first we have fixed that x1 and we have first written this summation by considering x1 fix. So, again I repeat, here we keep x1 as it is, we vary x2 from 0 to 3. So, if we take x2 equal to 0, we have x1 minus 0 p of x1 comma 0. If we take x2 equal to 1, we have x1 minus 1 px1 1. Similarly, for x2 equal to 2, we have x1 minus 2 px1 2. And for x2 equal to 3, we have x1 minus 3 px1 3. So, first we have written this summation by considering x1 as fixed variable. Now, here we vary x1 from 0 to 4. So, first we take x1 equal to 0. So, if I take x1 equal to 0 everywhere here, I will obtain this first line. Okay, this is for x1 equal to 0. x1 is 0, that is 0 minus 0 p of 0 0. Then x1 equal to 0 again, 0 minus 1 p 0 1, 0 minus 2 p 02, 0 minus 3, p 03. So, this is for x1, x1 equal to 0. Similarly, we consider x1 equal to 1 and we will have 1 minus 0, p 10. So, that you can see here, for x1 equal to 1, 1 minus 0, p 10. If I take x1 equal to 1 here, 1 minus 1, p 11. For x1 equal to 1 here, I obtain 1 minus 2 p12. For x1 equal to 1 here, I obtain 1 minus 3 p13. Then I take x1 equal to 2 and I obtain 2 minus 0 p20, 2 minus 1 p21, 2 minus 2 p22, 2 minus 3 p23. Then x1 is 3, so I have 3 minus 0 p30, 3 minus 1 p31, 3 minus 2 p32, and 3 minus 3 p33. And finally, I take x1 equal to 4, I have 4 minus 0 p40, 4 minus 1 p41, 4 minus 2 p42, and 4 minus 3 p43. Now, we are having all these values in the table. So, for example, these values for x1 equal to 0 are in the first row. Okay, these values correspond to x1 equal to 0. So, I have written these values 0.08, 0.07, 0.04 and 0. So, first value is 0, then 0.07, 0.04, 0. Then I use these values p10, p11, p12, okay, and in this way we substitute all the required values of joint probability mass function from this table. For example, for x1 equal to 1, first value is 0.06. So, we have taken this p10 as 0.06, okay, that is here, 1 into 0.06. So, in this way, I have substituted all these values of joint probability mass function, and after doing calculations, I obtain that expected value of x1 minus x2 is 0.15. That is, the expected difference is 0.15. Okay, so, this is very easy. You just have to remember this definition, and then first we fix x1, we vary for x2 equal to 0 to 3, and after that we vary from x1 equal to 0 to 4, and we substitute values of all these joint probability mass function values from the given table, and we can easily calculate 0.15. but we have to be careful while substituting all these values. If there is a single mistake, then we may get the wrong answer. So this is one way of getting the expected difference in this example. Now this same problem we can do using that property of linear combination. As we have seen, expected value of ax plus by can be written as a times expected value of x plus b times expected value of y. So using this property, I can write this as expected value of x1 minus expected value of x2. So if we want to use this property, then we have to calculate expected value of x1 and x2 separately. For that, we require marginal probability mass functions of x1 and x2, and we are familiar with the marginal probability mass functions. If we are interested in the marginal probability mass function of, say, random variable x1, then as we have discussed earlier, marginal probability mass function of random variable x1 is obtained by taking summation of values of joint probability mass function for all possible values of x2. So here x2 is from 0 to 3, and this we have to do for all possible values of x1, that is x1 equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So as we know that if we consider this sum of entries in the first row, then this will give us value of marginal probability mass function at x1 equal to 0. So in that way we can calculate probability mass functions of x1 and x2, and then we can use that result. So that also I have done here. I have written that table again. Before that we just recall that marginal probability of x, probability mass function of x1 is summation of p x1 x2, where x2 takes the values from 0 to 3 for x1 equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose we calculate for x1 equal to 0, then here we fix x1 equal to 0, x2 is from 0 to 3. So this summation equals, if we take x2 equal to 0, we have p 0, 0. If we take x2 equal to 1, we have p 0, 1. For x2 equal to 2, we have p 0, 2. And for x2 equal to 3, we have p 0, 3. So these are the entries in the first row of this table, p 0, 0, p 0, 1, p 0, 2 and p 0, 3. This is p 0, 0, p 0, 1, p 0, 2, p 0, 3. So this total in the first row gives us the value of probability mass function of x1 at x1 equal to 0. So if we sum all these entries, we obtain 0.19. So first row sum gives us the p of 0 for random variable x1. Similarly, total in the second row will give us value of probability mass function of x1 at x1 equal to 1. Similarly, this total corresponding to third row or corresponding to x1 equal to 2 will give us p of 2 for random variable x1, and p of 3 is the total corresponding to this x1 equal to 3, and p of 4 is the total corresponding to x1 equal to 4. So these are the values of probability mass function of random variable x1. Similarly, we can say that this marginal probability mass function of x2 is given by sigma p x1 x2, for all possible values of x1 equal to 0 to 4. So if we consider for x2 equal to 0, then we can see that x1 is 0 to 4 p of x1 comma 0, we take x2 equal to 0. Now we vary x1 from 0 to 4, so we have p 0 plus p 10 plus p 20 plus p 30 plus p 40. So these are the values in the first column, they correspond to x2 equal to 0. So column total or total in the first column will give us the marginal probability mass function of x2 at x2 equal to 0. So if we take the total of first column, total of all these entries, this is value of marginal probability mass function of x2 at x2 equal to 0. Similarly, if we take the total corresponding to x2 equal to 1, then this is nothing but p of 1 for random variable x2. Similarly, we obtain p of 2 and p of 3 for random variable x2. So in short, we recall that row total will give us marginal probability of random variable x1 and column total will give us marginal probability mass function of random variable x2. So now we can find out expected value of x1. By definition, expected value of x1 is summation x1 times p of x1 for random variable x1. X1 takes the values from 0 to 4. So if we take x1 equal to 0, we have 0 into p of 0. For x1 equal to 1, we have 1 into p of 1. For x2 equal to 2, we have 2 into p of 2. Then x3 equal to 3 will give us 3 into p of 3. And for x1 equal to 4, we have 4 into p of 4. Now we are having all these values p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, 3 and 4. So these are those values p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, p of 3 and p of 4. So we have substituted all these values here and we obtain that expected value of x1 is 1.7. Similarly, we obtain expected value of x2. By definition, it is sigma x2 times p of x2. x2 takes the values from 0 to 3. So for x2 equal to 0, we have p 0 into p of 0. For x2 equal to 1, we have 1 into p of 1, then 2 into p of 2 plus 3 into p of 3. So these are the values of marginal probability mass function of x2 at x2 equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. That also we have obtained in the table. So we have substituted all these values of marginal probability mass function of x2 and we have obtained expected value of x2. So after substituting all these values and doing calculations, we obtain that expected value of x2 is 1.55 and expected value of x1 was 1.7. So now expected value of x1 minus x2 is expected value of x1 minus expected value of x2. Substituting these values, we obtain this same value which we obtain by definition. So the expected difference is 0.15. So there are two ways of doing this type of problems. If you wish, you can go by definition, and if you find this one easy, then you can use this one also. Okay, this is by that result, that expected value of linear combination of x1 and x2 is expected value of x1 minus expected value of x2. Okay, fine. So in this lecture, we have defined expected value of function of two-dimensional random variable and using definition as well as one result, we obtain expected value of a given function of x and y. So we will just remember this definition. If you are asked to find out expected value of a function of two-dimensional discrete random variable, then we will use this double summation hxy into pxy. and if we are asked to find out expected value for function of two-dimensional continuous random variable, then we will use this one, double integral of hxy times joint probability mass function of x and y, mass joint probability density function. Here f is joint PDF, here p is joint probability mass function. So we will discuss problems related to two-dimensional continuous random variable in the next lecture, and we stop here. This is all about this session. I hope you like it. Thank you very much.